Do you want to go live on YouTube quickly and easily? Well, good, because that's exactly what you're going to be able to do by the end of this video. I'm going to show you how to go live on YouTube without using third-party software. While there are lots of third-party tools out there that will give you lots more functionality and more professional live streams, here's the secret. You don't have to start there. You can go live on YouTube with nothing other than a laptop and a YouTube account. I'm gonna show you everything you need to know to use YouTube's built-in tools, and be sure to stick around till the end, because guess what? I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. It's one of the biggest mistakes I see almost every beginner live streamer make. Let's make sure you don't make that mistake too. There are no rules or limits of who can go live on YouTube. Now, while streaming from your phone actually requires 1,000 subscribers, as long as you're streaming from your laptop or your desktop, all you need to do is make sure your live streaming is activated on your channel. All you're gonna do to activate your channel is click on the plus video sign and click go live. Once that's done, remember it can take up to 24 hours for live streaming to become active on your channel, so be sure to plan ahead. Now let's take a look at how you actually go live. Click the video plus icon and click go live. That will take you to the live streaming dashboard with all of the integrated tools. Now it's automatically going to take you to where you need to go, but if you happen to click away, just make sure you are choosing webcam, and then all you want to do is choose your title. We're going live. Choose whether you want it to be public or unlisted. Of course, public is really what you want if you want your audience to see it. You can actually schedule this for later, and you can pick it up right here from the same interface. The benefit of scheduling a stream is so that you have a link to promote that out to your email list, your social channels, etc. Then it'll allow more people to show up live than just relying on the YouTube notifications. Now, through the magic of editing, I've already scheduled a stream so that we can pick that up. You're going to go to the left-hand side of the screen and click manage. And then in order to get the shareable link, click the hamburger menu, and you can either edit it, but you can just get shareable link, and that'll copy it to your clipboard, go promote it. And then when you're ready to actually go live, just click on that video and you're ready to go. Now, I'm not going to choose to schedule later. We're gonna go live now, and then choose the audience. Is it made for kids or is it not? You can go into the description when you click more options. You can edit everything. You can choose your category. You can choose your camera, your microphone, if you have those USB options plugged in. And then you're going to click next. Now, before we go on, I recommend testing before you go live publicly. And the way we do that, and the way we're going to do this stream, is by choosing to go unlisted. Then we're gonna click next, and it's gonna ask you to smile for a thumbnail. And you'll see the title, you'll see the category, you'll see the privacy setting before you click go live. Now, while I posed for a silly thumbnail, it's always ideal to make sure that you actually prepare your thumbnails in advance. Make them look good, because this doesn't look so good. If you want to change that, you can actually retake the thumbnail, or you can upload a custom thumbnail. All right. It's time to go live, but we're testing, so it's no big deal, right? Go live! And we're going live, going live, going live. It's processing, you're live! Yay! So it tells you when you're live. So at that point, just get going and start talking. In this interface, you will be able to see how long you've been live. You'll see that you're live. That red button is your alert. You'll see the number of views and likes that you have. And then over here, you'll see the chat room. You can even chat with them as well. Now, as far as the interface goes, there are a couple of things that you might want to pay attention to in order to manage your stream while you're live. If you don't have a moderator, then when somebody does leave a mean comment like Mitch did, and I'm very hurt right now, you can actually hover over the comment, click the three dots beside it, and you can either report or remove or put the user in timeout or you can even hide the user on this channel, meaning that they're still commenting, yet no one sees it. So they're just commenting to the abyss. Or you can add them as a moderator. However, since Mitch was mean, I'm not gonna do that. Now, beside live chat, there's also a little hamburger menu that you can click and see who's watching, the participants, but you can also pop out that chat. Let's say you have a second monitor and you prefer to watch that in a bigger space. You'll see your audio meter down here. You can always mute it, unmute it, and you can share your live video as well. Grab that link without having to go into Creator Studio and in your video manager. When you're ready to end the stream, you're just gonna click end stream. It's going to double check and then you're actually done. Now at this point you get some analytics. You get to celebrate the success of your live stream. How many concurrent viewers did you get? How many new subscribers came out of that live stream? How long did they watch and how long was your stream? These are all great things to know about your content. And of course you can dive deeper into analytics as the replay continues. Since I know you're wanting to put your brand's best foot forward, you do need to understand the limitations of streaming from YouTube's integrated tool. It will not be the highest quality live stream. However, it is easy to get started quickly. Don't let anything hold you back from actually taking action. But to understand the quality difference better, I describe this in the four levels of live streaming. Level one is your phone. You go live, it's super easy, super quick. You have everything you need. Level two is browser or cloud-based services, just like I showed you on YouTube.com or Facebook.com. Now, level three is going live from third-party software downloaded onto your computer, whether you're on a Mac or PC, and this gives you a lot more control over the quality that you send out. And then level four is adding additional gear to your studio so that it's push-button simple. Now, you want that little secret I told you I'd share? Here it is. Because I told you that live video can be so easy, people often think that they don't have to plan ahead, and that's a big mistake, one I don't want you to make. So I want you to be intentional about your live video content creation so that you can maximize the results you get from it, both live and on the replay. Here are three things you can do to get the most out of your streams. One, make the title spot on. Keyword researching your live stream title is just as important as recorded videos if you're creating searchable content. YouTube will favor your live stream while you're live if you make that title searchable. And the thumbnail, oh my gosh, always important, right? Live video, no different. Number two, promote your streams in advance. Don't expect that if you go live, they will come. You need to take control of your viewership rather than leaving it in the hands of the algorithm. So use your social media, your email list, and any other assets you have to promote ahead of time. Number three, make sure you plan for the best performance from your computer. Live streaming is, well, live. It's not if something is going to go wrong, it's when. So be sure to close background syncing apps like Google Drive or Dropbox. Close any applications you're not using during your stream. Do a fresh reboot before you go live. All of these things can help you have a better, smoother stream. And if you want to learn more about developing a live video strategy, be sure to watch this video next. And if you want to learn more about third-party software to take your quality up a level, click here.